a child that's independent to go and to search from birth has a direction in life forever. You will see a lot of examples in the development of the child. If you go to a traditional place, and at a good traditional daycare, and I believe very good education exists outside Montessori, with very similar principles of respecting the person. But many other things are very, very deficient for educating the human being. If you go to a place in which the child cannot touch without an adult giving, may I do this, may I do that, or does everything without any direction or any interest deeper than just manipulating, you don't have the same results as we have in Montessori. Reading, for instance, the child that relates to sounds is a child that by 3.5 and 4, normally before 4, is able to do the first reading. I had one of my grandchildren the other day making a picture and signing his name, T-O-M, to send to grandma. But the development of the muscles for writing letters is much slower than the mental development. So he wrote the T, the O, and then he put a C. And he looked at his daddy and told, I didn't write Tom, I wrote talk. I told the father, he's reading. First experience for me of seeing this little one reading. So an environment that allows the child to discover, to relate, is an environment in which he can grow. Language is an aspect that is so depending on the parents and the educators. The parents need to talk to the children. The children need to know what's going on in the world. It needs to have really good human relationships. And from birth on, we talk. We have to talk a lot with our children. And the intellectual development depends a lot on this too.